in. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up, you guys? It's Graph Farms here with another video, and today we are going to be back on Dad's Farm. We're still in the midst of harvest. We have finished field one, and we are currently on field two. As you can see, I'm just putting chop straw down. The reason for that being, because if you see here, we've made 16 bales and haven't even gone all the way around the field. So I'm thinking that we'll get plenty of straw. From just this field, do have a little bit of the first round on field two that is in straw that I'll have to go and pick up. But yeah, I'm pretty sure that we'll get quite enough straw. So yeah, as you can see, rented a 4430 and the Heston 5680 for the day, or 5580, sorry, for a day, and then also a 4630 and then the bale trailer, and we're going to work on picking up some bales here in a moment. But what we need to do right now is we need to haul this load to the farm and get it put in the bin. It's not quite a full load, but it's not worth waiting for the grain cart to fill and then doing it that way. So we're just going to haul it to the farm. We have filled one grain bin. So we have 250,000 liters of wheat, and then we're working on bin number two. As you can see, our corn is looking mighty fine. Our beans are also looking pretty dang good. Yeah, so we're rocking right along with the harvest. Our yield, I should say, is very awesome. We're getting a pretty dang good yield off of our crops, so that is very good. Yeah, I don't think anything else has happened there. If you guys haven't seen last week's video, I guess I should say, sorry for no videos Tuesday and Saturday last week. I wasn't available to, or I wasn't around to record video. So yeah, I just didn't get a chance to do that. But if you didn't see Thursday's video, I'll just kind of give you a, ooh, we're going to drive into our soybean field. I'll just give you a little update. I have gotten down to the farm, my papa's farm, to be exact, I should say. I have gotten down there and have gotten pictures of all the buildings that I need. There's three buildings that I didn't get pictures of because we ran out of time. But those ones I can do from memory and Google Earth, so I'm good on those. And then the house, I'm actually not doing the same house that's there. I'm doing a house that I found in SketchUp that I really, really like, and I've got it in Blender and currently been working on redoing it. I'm gonna sort it out into pieces, and then I'm also going to do AO textures on it. We're going to have to pull this ahead. Oops, too far now. I hate when that happens. Dang thing will not stay, and I cannot figure out why. I cannot get this dang tractor to stay in one spot. Just keeps sliding all the time and gets really annoying. Oh, would help if I turn the auger back on. There we go. So yeah, as you can see, we have this first bin here is full. And we're working on bin number two. Right over here, I can see that this door is open, so we'll shut that. Let's just check this guy. Grain cart should be on his way over there. Should, but he's being completely stupid and doing cookies around a telephone pole. But yeah, so I've been putting in a lot of time now again on my map, getting the fields finished up. The other day, forget what day it was, but I got a few fields done. And getting closer and closer to being done with the fields. I still do have a lot of fields left to do, but it's getting closer. So yeah, what else was I gonna say about it? But yeah, so I'm gonna be starting the buildings fairly soon. I'm not exactly 100% of when I'm gonna start the buildings. But I will be getting them started eventually. I did do a little shed. Once we get the truck parked, I'll show you that. I'll show you guys the shed in the house here in just a moment. But I found a little shed in SketchUp that I ran through Blender and made it a little bit nicer. Put it in Blender and joined all the pieces up together. Because with SketchUp, you know, you have to explode the model and it creates like zillions of pieces, it seems. But anyway, I joined every piece together, removed all doubles and recalculated the faces, and then separated everything into pieces like I have. The roof is separate. The big door is separate. The walkthrough door is separate. The trim around the doors is separate. And then the floor is separate. The building isn't functional. You know, it'll just be at one of the surrounding area farms. But then I did AO textures on all the pieces and whatnot. Added edge split so that it's, you know, not kind of rough model. It makes it, edge split smooths models out. Makes them a lot smoother and nicer. So yeah, we're going to get the truck pulled up to right here. Right there. We'll check on our baler here. It's still not even done with the first round, and we're at 27 bales. Yeah, we're definitely going to be hauling straw for quite a while. So we'll jump to this guy, and we'll jump onto my desktop and show you guys here. I'll show you guys the farmhouse first. So it loads up here. So here is the house. Nothing special yet. So separated out the concrete for like in the garage and on the porch. Because that'll be just kind of concreted up on the porch here. We have the two garage doors. And then we have the meter here in the back. And we have all of the porch lights here. And then I have the roof taken off, the window frames all taken off, and we have the windows themselves, and then we have the porch, and then the shutters. And then, I'll show you guys here, we have service hall. Show you guys this. So here's our service hall. Kind of did somewhat similar to what this original SketchUp model had. Had a red roof, and then it was a white steel building, but I kind of like this kind of creamy white. And then went to Google and found a garage door texture picture and put that on there, and then like a steel texture. And then I used Lynn JP's concrete. So since you can't really see inside of the building. So, all right, I gotta take a quick pause. I'm gonna go eat quick, and then I will. All right, and we're back. All right, let's get that going again. All right, so I'm gonna turn this down to 10. Let's turn on the loading. I think we can only go about 15 with this. Is the fastest that we can go. Nope, that's too fast. Let's try 12, maybe. Really, that's the fastest that this thing can pull it? All right, then. So we will snap a screenshot here. Wow, this is sad. I think I'm gonna have to rethink my tractor. Oh. That would also have something to do with it. Jeez, I didn't even notice that I wasn't in. That I was only in first gear. I think we can go 15. So for now, what we're going to do is just stack the bales. Jeez, I wonder if this tractor... Yeah, this tractor's only in... Jeez, no wonder why it's going so slow. I forgot to put it in a higher gear. I'm just going to be stacking these bales in the grass over by... next to the sale barn for the time, just because I don't have a loader and all that stuff, and I don't want to rent one right now. I'll just wait until we buy one, and then we can, so we've made 35 bales already, holy smoke, but, yeah, so I'll just wait until we can afford to buy a loader, tractor, and stuff. I think this holds 22. Which is not bad. One more. And there we are. You can see I had a little, I ran the combine on that little strip there and accidentally hit the wrong button and ended up chopping straw for a moment and then had to fix that. I don't know why it has an international logo on the steering wheel, but it does, for whatever reason. Has the infamous annoying car horn. Oh, Only bad thing about course play is you miss so much, but with the way our wheat's yielding, I don't think that'll be an issue. Alright, so let's figure out our unload. How do we want to stack these? I think what I might do is just make a long row of them. And yeah, I don't want to sit back up, so we need to change our unload side. I'll go unload side M. I want to unload on the right hand side. Really? I hate that when autosave kicks in, if there's anything on there, they all come flying off. Alright, so there's load one. Is there anything in our truck right now? Nope, not a thing. I wonder, maybe this field must not be yielding as well. I think it's probably because that field was slurry. Had slurry on it. It's probably why. Oh well, we're still, even with it like that, we're still getting a pretty dang good yield, so I ain't gonna complain. So this guy is on his second headland. Meanwhile, we're gonna run up here back to where we were and continue picking bales up. So I guess it's definitely not going to be a bad thing that we're not yielding as much, because I won't have to be as rushed to do stuff, but definitely wouldn't be nicer to have a large yield, but oh well, we'll have plenty of grain, and when we sell, we'll be waiting until we hit the great demand. So once all the crops are harvested and in the bins, what we'll do is fast forward time until we hit a great demand for one of our crop types that we have, whether it be wheat or soybeans or corn, or else if, you know, like, let's check the prices now. Wow, canola is pretty good. Soybeans are really good. So, you know, if our crop is running really, really well at that particular time, then we won't wait for a great demand if we have a certain crop that's sitting pretty well. But, you know, like if our corn or wheat is, you know, under like 300 or something like that, or maybe under 500, you know, not that great, then we will, great. We have a couple bales in the field. That's fun. Yeah, if our yield, oh, it did get that. Awesome. Or if the prices aren't that great, then we will just wait for a great demand. I don't want to do that. I don't want to have to drive through all this. We're going to kind of have to a little bit here. Can't be helped. But, yeah, so hopefully we don't have any bales anywhere else. But, yeah, so that way we can get the most money that we possibly can, because we're going to need a lot of money to get started on beef. Shoot. Forgot. Need to get that guy going. So now that he's running a lot slower yield, this guy can be set to go at about 80%, I think. Drive on at 100. So he's going to fill. See, I did not save his course. F2 grain cart. One second. Theta! Shush! Stupid dog is annoying. So we gotta be up there quite a ways now with our bales. So yeah, definitely, we will definitely be sitting perfectly off of just this one field, in terms of straw. You know, we definitely can, we have a lot of spaces that we can cut grass. You know, we can cut around all of these fields. We can cut, you know, like, where we're stacking our bales. And there's many other places of just plain grass, so we'll have plenty of areas to cut. No, 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 you dumb thing. Ugh, I hate that. It's the worst thing about using an autoloader trailer is that it does stupid things like that. So I'm not too worried about picking up every little bit here. Now it'll, soil mod will use it for fertilizer, so it'll, as time progresses, it'll just get, it'll just disappear, won't do anything, it'll just disappear, so, our combine has blown a pretty fair amount of dust, and I think actually, let's turn this on. Yeah, turn on animated chopper. There we go. That's a lot nicer. So our grain cart is finally filling. Actually, back our truck up just a little bit. Right there. So we're up at 62 bales already. Holy smokes. See, I don't want to just leave the bales sit in the field, mainly because they could start rolling, and also just because I don't want to have them be in the way, because we will probably end up starting field work before we can afford our animal equipment, so maybe, anyways, or else at the same time. So then we'd be in a hurry to try and get all the bales off before the cultivators get to it. And before we, well, the applicator, actually, because we'll be knifing in some NPK after harvest. Not till after we finish selling off our grain and stuff, though, because if we sit and just fast forward time, our NPK will just go to waste, which really, I guess, our nutrients will drop heavily if we just sit fast forward time, but then we get the fun chore of managing our nutrients, so we'll be able to inject NPK, and then we can spread more NPK later on if needed. You can hook more than one of these together. Really should do that, so that way we can try and keep up with the baler. But I think we'll be just fine. So, this is your Tuesday video. I'm recording this Monday, Monday morning here. And your Thursday video, I don't know what I'm gonna be doing. If I can get a lot more fields done and be to where I'm almost finished with fields on my map, then I will do a video on my map. But if I still have a lot of fields left by, I'll say Wednesday night or Thursday morning, then we'll probably be back on here. And there's a bale down there. Oh, man. Jeez. We'll have to wait for the combine to get close to that. That way we don't have to drive over the crop to get that one. There we go. We got another full load. So yeah, like I said, if I have almost all the fields done on my map, then I will do a video on there to finish up the fields, or else I will just be back on here. God, I hate that. It gets very annoying to have to be worrying about that even. Right, a little bit further. There we go. Perfect. Jeez, he's dumping another bale. Holy cow, we're gonna have, I'm gonna say 200 bales by the time we're done baling here. I won't be surprised if we have 200 or so. Wow, that's ridiculous. Gotta love the Giants bale physics, where every single bale rolls. I mean, yeah, they do roll in real life, but not as easily or as much as these bales. This is ridiculous. Holy smokes, he's dumping another one. He definitely doesn't get very far before it dumps. Let him turn around, I think. Oh, he's gonna hit that bale. There we go. No, he's not. So very naval cruise. Not trying to do this myself. All right. Think now we'll just kind of let the baler get ahead a little ways. Although he kind of is. Let's run over here and shut this guy off. We're wasting fuel. Let's see what else we got going around. Two. So we have to figure out where we're gonna stack all this hay. I think I am going to go and edit this map. I'm going to remove the clip on the trees at that farm. I'm not going to remove the farm. I'll leave it there. But I'll just get rid of the clip on the trees. And then what I'm going to do is I think this building has, well, maybe not. I thought this building had, things in it for like your silage and that kind of stuff, but it must not. Maybe it does, but if this does have all, no, I deleted them, that's right. Okay, I remember now. So yeah, this is where we'll stack all of our bales, and then we will need to make some silage. Actually, what we should do, but we can't afford that. I was gonna say we could rent a chopper, a pickup header and then a truck and trailer, and we could chop the straw, but I don't know how well that would work. Maybe it would. Let's see. Harvesters. We could rent. Maybe, do I still have New Holland one? No, I don't. There's our timer. So yeah, we could rent the 8600i. So that'd be free to rent because of the screwed up price. And this, if we rent this for a day, that's free as well. So for a truck and trailer, we'd want this guy. We rented that for a day, that'd be 7,000. And for a truck, we could get... what could we get? We could get the Scott. Or we could get the T6. This is only $1 an hour. And we could rent this one and... okay, yeah. So let's jump in our combine. Actually, we'll just do it on two fields over there, I think is what we'll do. Let's request our tractor here. So guys, that's gonna about do it for me today. I off camera will get the baling finished and finish stacking the bales, and then we'll get that field finished. And if I don't get started on those fields, then we'll start on those fields in the next episode and then work on chopping, I think. So yeah, guys, if you enjoyed the video, make sure you hit that thumbs up button and subscribe if you have not already. Make sure that you turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. My video schedule is Tuesdays and Thursdays at 4 p.m. Central Time and Saturdays at noon. Make sure you check out down below in the description for links to all my social medias, my mod site, and other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.